Boo-hoo.
He likes his Isla.
He's so cute. You can tell he likes to have fun.
You did so good.
Yeah, good job. Angela's getting ready to go on. The show is going to be awesome. Angela's about to go on. Angela's the best. We already know that.
Look down.
All righty. As soon as it's quiet, you may begin. Zach, is it you that begins?
Yeah.
Okay.
The Lord's Prayer, based on the book by Chris Van Osburgh.
On Christmas Eve, many years ago, I lay quietly in my bed. I did not rustle the sheets. I breathed slowly and silently. I was listening for a sound a friend had told me I never hear ringing bells and Santa's sleigh.
There is no Santa.
My friend insisted, but I knew he was wrong. Late that night, I did hear the sounds, though not of ringing bells from outside, came the sound of the hissing steam and squeaking metal. I looked through my window and saw in an apron with steam snowflakes so lightly around it. A conductor stood at the open door of one of the cars. He took a large pocket watch from his vest, then looked up at my window. I put on my slippers and wore open. I tiptoed downstairs and out the door.
All aboard!
The conductor cried. Out I ran up to him.
Well, are you coming?
Where?
Why, to the North Pole.
This is the Polar Express. I took his outstretched hand and he pulled me up aboard. The train was filled with other children, all in their pajamas and nightgowns. We sang Christmas carols and ate candies with nougat centers as white as snow. We drank the hot cocoa as thick and rich as melted chocolate bars. Outside, the lights of towns and villages flickered in the distance as the Polar Express raced north. Soon there were no more lights to be seen. We traveled through cold, dark forces where lean wolves roamed and white-tailed rabbits. He hid from out our train as it thundered through the quiet wilderness. We climbed mountains so high it seemed as if we could scrape the moon, but the Polar Express never slowed down. Faster and faster we ran along, rolling over peaks and through valleys like a car or a roller coaster.
The mountains turned into hills, the hills to snow-covered plains. We crossed a barren
ceiling of the frozen sea.
There is the North Pole.
Silver.
The North Pole, it was a huge city standing alone at the top of the world. Filled with factories where every Christmas toy was made. At first we saw no elves. They are gathering at the center of the city.
That's what told us.
That is where Santa will give the first gift of Christmas.
Who receives the first gift?
We all ask.
He will choose one of you.
Look,
shouted one of the children.
What else?
Outside, we saw hundreds of elves as our train drew close to the center of the North Pole. There is snow. We're slowed to a crawl, so crowded where the streets with Santa's helpers when the polar express.
We pressed through the crowd to the edge of a large open circle. In front of us stood Santa's sleigh, the reindeers. The reindeer were excited. They pranced in haste, ringing the silver bells that hung from the harnesses. In the magical sound, like nothing I've ever heard, across the circle, the elves moved up. Appeared, the elves cheered loudly and rushed over to us and pointed to me and
said, "Let's have this fellow here."
He jumped into this sleigh, then the conductor handed me up. I sat on his knee and he asked,
"What will you like for Christmas?"
I knew that I could have any gift I could imagine, but the thing I wanted most for Christmas was not inside Santa's giant bag. What I wanted more than anything was a silver bell from Santa's sleigh. When I asked, Santa smiled. Then he gave me a hug and told an elf to cut a bell from the reindeer's harness. The elf tossed it up to Santa. He stood holding the bell high above him and called out, "The first gift of Christmas." What? I yelled to him, and
He cupped his hands around his mouth.
Merry Christmas!
Oh, that's too bad.